Hey guys, this is Kayla with Becky's Graphic Design in Nashville, Tennessee. And today I'll be showing you how to do some more advanced editing on your ebook, especially one that you have exported from Adobe InDesign and need a little more fine-tuning to get it exactly how you want it. InDesign does a decent job of exporting books as EPUB formats, but there are some things that it cannot do. For example, there is no way for us to apply a text wrap to an image with the default settings from InDesign. However, we can go in and manually apply what's called a float style to it in order to allow the image to float to the left or to the right of the text. To do this, I'm going to be editing the code of the ebook, and I'm going to edit it using a program called Sigil, which can be found here. Sigil is a free code editing software, and it helps you navigate your ebook without breaking it or without messing it up. The URL for Sigil can be found here at this URL. It's free to download. All right, so let's have a look at our ebook. Here's an ebook with several images in it. I'm primarily going to be focusing on this cruise ship image right now. How do we open this up in the code in? I'm going to navigate to where my file is contained. Here's my EPUB. And I'm going to right click and tell it to open in Sigil, because if I double click this to open right now, it will open by default with Kindle Previewer 3. I want to indicate I'm opening with Sigil. So I'm going here to Sigil. And now Sigil will open up this EPUB in code format. When it opens up, it's probably going to give me a warning that the files have not been well formed, which is true. InDesign does kind of a messy job of the file creation of the EPUB itself. Yep, here's this pop-up warning. I'm going to click yes. And here we are. Now don't freak out. I know it looks like a lot of meaningless strings of words and text, but it's not too bad to navigate, really. As we can see, we have our table of contents over here on the side. This is one of my favorite parts of Sigil, the way it displays the table of contents. Now the cruise ship image is contained in chapter 3, so I'm going to navigate to here. Now I'm going to scroll down and look for the code that contains the cruise ship image. Here it is, the cruise ship JPEG. Now there's a couple things I'm going to change here. This image does not really need to be in container. InDesign likes to create several different wrappers and containers that the cruise ship goes inside of. You know how the frames work in InDesign. This is not really necessary though in code. So I'm going to get rid of the container and I'm going to allow this class to remain, object layout one. So I'm going to get rid of this div and this div, and then the corresponding end divs. And the caption that was with it, we won't worry about that for now. Okay, how do I edit the attributes for this particular image? In Sigil, you can right click on the class and go to the link or style. What I'm going to change here is I'm going to add something called float. Float right, let's say. Now float is something that has come up with the more new versions of HTML and code and CSS. So this may not work if you're using a particularly old ebook device. I'm not sure if it will or not. But in this instance, we can use it. I'm going to add a display of inline block because I want the image to go along with the text as if it is part of it. And then I'm going to reduce the width to to 50% of each. I'm going to change the height to auto. And the minimum width, I will change to 30%. I'm going to go up and click the Save button on the top. And let's have a look at artwork. I'm going to go back and open up my file again. Close all of these. No, I don't want to install a new version. Thank you. Navigate back to my file. Open it in Kindle Previewer 3. Go to Chapter 3. And there we are. Now our cruise ship image is floating on this side of the page. And it has come all the way to the very middle of the page because that is the 50% width right there. Now this is a bit tight on that text. So let's add a padding and margin to it. Let's go back to our code. This is again the attributes for the particular image. I'm going to add a couple more categories. We're going to add a category of padding. Let's do 10 pixels for that. And I'm going to add another category for margin. And also 10 pixels for that. The difference between padding and margin is padding is something that goes inside your container, like you would when you're packing a box for shipping. The padding is the extra stuff that goes inside. Margin is what is contained on the outside of the container, adds extra white space exterior of it. I'm adding a little bit of both. Let's hit save. And we're gonna go back and reopen up our ebook again, close the old version, open it up again. Wait. Let's go to chapter 3, find our cruise ship image, and yep, there it is. Now it has a nice little amount of padding and margin around it so it's not flowing directly into the text. One last thing we're going to talk about is the caption for this image, which I deleted earlier. Go back to our code. I'm going to go back to this tab on the top to go to the content for chapter 3. I'm leaving the style sheet behind now. I'm going to add a new paragraph style, or a new paragraph, I should say, with a class of, what is it, caption maybe? Yep, there it is, pcaption, that's what I called it. Okay, I'm going to go back to now. I'm going to tell it to have a class of caption. And we'll put the text inside. Close out the paragraph. This paragraph should stay inside of this other wrapper div. Hit save and see what we get. Open up again, one more time. Oh, I see. So because we applied the float to this image, but not to the wrapper, this caption is hanging outside now. So let's go see if we can fix this problem. I'm going to go back to my code. I'm going to go back to my style sheet. I'm going to get back there by clicking on my wrapper and the class for it, right-clicking, going to link or style. And I'm going to go ahead and pull these things that I had placed on here. Now they're going to go this wrapper. I click save. see what we get. There we are. Now that we have applied that float to the wrapper all the way around both of these items, now there has been a float applied to both this image and the caption that is associated with it. Now take note, that caption style that I talked about was something that was generated by InDesign. It may not be caption on your end. You may have to create a style for it or pull the class of a different style. Whatever it was you named your captions in InDesign, that's what you need to target. All right, everybody, I hope that helped. I will see you in the next video. If you have any comments or questions, leave them in the section below, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.